Hello investors, welcome back to Explore the Finance. Today we are shining a spotlight on a company that has weathered the storm and emerged stronger than ever. Once standing on the brink of bankruptcy, this company has orchestrated one of the most remarkable turnarounds in the renewable energy sector. From massive debts and financial turmoil to a leaner, profitable powerhouse, its story is nothing short of inspirational. Yes, I'm talking about Suzlon Energy Limited. But kuch saal pehle tak company bahut hi difficult phase se guzar rahi thi, bahut challenges the. Company ke karz bahut zyada badh chuke the aur company ke operational setbacks ki wajah se company ka future bahut hi kamzor dikhai de raha tha. But where others saw failure, Suzlon saw an opportunity to rebuild and reimagine. आज अगर हम बात करें तो Suzlon की शेयर की प्राइस approximately 50 रुपए के आसपास ट्रेड कर रही है, लेकिन ये एक साल पहले 14 रुपए था. That means there is a jump of 257%. So in today's video, we will dive deep into Suzlon's incredible journey from near collapse to revitalization. We will try to understand what went wrong. The company, which has given only losses in these 18 years, has suddenly given 257% return to its shareholders. Whether this turn is sustainable in future? Can we expect the same return in future too? Should we do bulk investment in this company? We will try to find out all the answers to these questions in this video. But one disclaimer first, this is not a buy and sell recommendation video. Kindly do your due diligence before taking any investment decision. So in order to understand the turnaround story of Suzlon, we need to understand the reasons of downfall of Suzlon Energy. 1995 में Suzlon की शुरुआत तुलसी तांति ने की थी और 10 सालों के अंदर Suzlon आसमान की नई ऊंचाइयों को छू रहा था. In the year 2005, Suzlon launched its IPO at ₹123. Not only this, due to Suzlon, Tulsi Tanti was India's fourth richest person. यानी कि Suzlon कोई ऐसी छोटी मोटी कंपनी नहीं थी, ये दुनिया की पांचवी सबसे बड़ी विंड एनर्जी कंपनी बन चुकी थी. तो Suzlon का मेन काम था विंड टर्बाइन जनरेटर्स की मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करना एंड देन उसकी मेंटेनेंस या रखरखाव का काम करना. इन द ईयर 2005 इटसेल्फ तुलसी टांटी थॉट टू एक्सपैंड इट्स बिजनेस एंड थॉट व्हाई नॉट टू मैन्युफैक्चर दोस पार्ट्स व्हिच आर रिलेटेड टू विंड मिल्स. सो इन ऑर्डर टू डू दिस ही वाज हैविंग टू ऑप्शंस, ईदर टू स्टार्ट इट फ्रॉम अ स्क्रैच और हायर दोस कंपनीज व्हिच आर ऑलरेडी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग दीस पार्ट्स. सो ही ऑप्टेड फॉर सेकंड ऑप्शन. In the year 2006, he acquired Belgium-based company named Hansen, which was into the manufacturing of gearbox. And in the year 2007, he also acquired German wind turbine manufacturing company called Senvion in $1.6 billion deal. अब इन कंपनीज को एक्वायर करने के लिए जो कैपिटल की जरूरत थी वो तुलसी टांटे के पास थे नहीं. इन्होंने क्या किया, कुछ शेयर्स को प्लेज किया और कुछ कैपिटल जो मेजर पोर्शन ऑफ कैपिटल था उन्होंने बैंक से रेज किया. एंड यहाँ से सीरीज ऑफ प्रॉब्लम स्टार्ट होता है. ऑल्दो द डिसीजन टेकन बाय द कंपनी वाज गुड, इंटेंशन बिहाइंड द डिसीजन वाज आल्सो गुड, बट द कंपनी वाज नॉट फॉर्चुनेट इनफ टू कैपिटलाइज दिस डिसीजन. बिकॉज इन द ईयर 2008 इटसेल्फ देयर वाज अ मेजर फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस व्हिच हिट वेरी हार्ड टू दिस कंपनी. 2008 फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस के बाद की कंपनी के पास इनफ पैसा भी नहीं था कि वो इंटरेस्ट पे आउट करती. एंड इन द ईयर 2011 कंपनी मेड फर्स्ट डिफॉल्ट टू इट्स लोन. एंड प्रॉब्लम केवल यही खत्म नहीं होती है. इन द ईयर 2011 इटसेल्फ गवर्नमेंट विथड्रॉ इट्स इंसेंटिव प्रोग्राम विच दे वर गिवन टू विंड एनर्जी कंपनीज. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट 2011 से 2015 तक गवर्नमेंट ने एक भी टेंडर फ्लोट नहीं किया, जिसके वजह से कंपनी की हालत पूरी खराब हो चुकी. एंड द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस वाज द शिफ्ट ऑफ फोकस ऑफ गवर्नमेंट फ्रॉम विंड एनर्जी टू सोलर एनर्जी. अनदर मेजर ब्लो गिवन बाय द गवर्नमेंट वाज द रिवर्स ऑक्शन प्रोसेस फॉर द विंड एनर्जी कंपनीज. This was last nail in the coffin. So in conclusion, company was not having any future orders, government was not supporting, and interest were also piling up. So all this situation made very difficult for the company to function. There was no operational profit at all for many years. लेकिन कहते हैं ना, किस्मत हमेशा खराब नहीं होता. मैनेजमेंट की मेहनत और इंटेंशन की वजह से सिचुएशन अब डिफरेंट हो चुका है. बट ऐसा क्या हुआ जिसकी वजह से कंपनी अब प्रॉफिट की तरफ जा रही है? लेट्स फाइंड इट आउट. In the first move to become a profitable, Suzlon sold Senvion at ₹7,150 crores, which is 30% less than the price at which they had acquired this German company in the past. Further, company reduced its debts from ₹12,000 crore to ₹224 crores in financial year 2023-24 through debt to equity conversion. It simply means that the company has offered equity equivalent to the debt to the debtor of the company, thus increasing the capital, reducing the debt and increasing the profit. Ek teer se teen nishana. Second, company raised 2000 crores from qualified 8 institutional placements, out of which 1500 crores was used to pay the debt. So as on today, if you look at the balance sheet of the company, Suzlon's debt has reduced to ₹150 crores only. Therefore, we are seeing an increase in the net profit of the company from the last financial year itself. So chaliye, ye to ek bahut bada step tha ki debt ko reduce kiya gaya taki profit pe bahut bada impact aa sake, profit badh sake company ka. But ye profit continue rahe uske liye company ko chahiye kaam. So let's have a look at the future roadmap of the company too. So if you look at the current and the future work orders of Suzlon, it has largest ever order book of 3.3 gigawatts. If you look at the orders from the last financial year, in the year 2023, company secured a 69 megawatt order from Nordic Energy Company, 25.2 megawatt from Kumaraswamy Mineral Exports, 204 megawatt from Serentica Renewables. In the same year itself, company secured 300 megawatt order from Torrent Power Limited. Suzlon secures a new 225 megawatt order for the 3 megawatt series from Ever Renewable Energy Private Limited also. In the current financial year, Suzlon secured a new order of 81.9 megawatt for again that 3 megawatt series from Oyster Green Hybrid 1 Private Limited. And if you talk about the recent orders, on 11th of June 2024, company declared that Suzlon secured a 103.95 megawatt order from AMPI Energy Transitions. So to cut the long story short, company has enough work orders for today and tomorrow also, and it has also many orders in the pipeline too. Company ka jab time kharab chal raha tha to bahut sari negative cheeze ek saath hui, lekin jab time acha aaya to bahut sare positive cheeze bhi ek saath ho rahi hai. Government of India has committed that by 2027 to 2028, every year 10 gigawatt of wind tenders will be floated. And not only this, government has also taken a target to produce 5 million metric tons of green hydrogen, so that by 2030 125 gigawatt of power could be generated under National Green Hydrogen Mission. So from this positive move made by the government, Suzlon and other companies which are in the green energy field will be directly or indirectly benefited out of it. So when we look into the past, company was having no work orders, company was having huge debts, government support was also withdrawn. Now all these three things are in the place. Therefore, you will see that sales has grown by 25% in the last 3 years, profit has grown by 45% in the last 3 years, and stock price has also grown by 89% CAGR. So this was the complete presentation on Suzlon, its past, present and future. Now let's quickly jump on the conclusion. See, when we invest in any company, we do some research work, and in that research work we look for certain things like how the company is increasing its profit, revenue is increasing or not, the sector has enough potential for expansion of that company, company is expanding its total addressable market size by increasing its products, profits, government support and lot of things. So when we take this particular example of Suzlon, we have seen that debt has been restructured, it has reduced quite significantly, due to which we have seen there is an increase in the profit in the current financial year. Secondly, if the revenue of the company has to increase or the profit has also to increase, company should have a regular work order, and we have seen in the video that company has enough work order in the pipeline. Lastly, this sector has enough potential for expansion of such type of companies, because you know, not only India, the whole world is looking for alternate source of energy. When we talk especially in India, government is focused to promote the companies which are working in green energy sector, the trailer of which has already been highlighted in interim budget. And as we know, Suzlon is world's fifth largest wind turbine manufacturer company, therefore it has got all expertise and experience to derive maximum benefit out of it. So in conclusion, I am quite optimistic about this stock. FIIs are also quite optimistic, that's why they have increased their investment in the recent times. I have already invested quite significant amount in Suzlon and I'm sitting at a gain of 14%. So if you're a long-term investor, then definitely consider this stock keeping in your portfolio. Well, if you have a question with regard to Suzlon, please write in the comment box, and I know you haven't subscribed this channel yet, please do it right now.